As we celebrate our Disney Spirit Week this week, I thought it only appropriate to make one of my teacher read-alouds this week about the man who created it all, Walt Disney. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this brief biography of Walt Disney, written by Barbara Kramer. Who was Walt Disney? Have you ever been to Disneyland or Walt Disney World? Maybe you've seen Disney movies. The Lion King and Frozen are two of the most successful cartoon movies of all time. There are Disney clothes, toys, and books. The Disney name is everywhere, and it all started with one man, Walt Disney. Disney was the creator of Mickey Mouse, one of the best-known cartoon characters in the world. For Disney, those Mickey Mouse cartoons were just part of his success. Disney was a dreamer from the start, and his dreams kept getting bigger. Some people thought his ideas were too big or even impossible, but that did not stop Disney. Even though he sometimes failed, he never stopped trying new things. He changed the way cartoons were made. He also created a new type of movie. With imagination and hard work, Disney made his dreams come true. He made our world a more fun place to be. Early years. Walter Elias Disney was born on December 5, 1901 in Chicago, Illinois, USA. He was the youngest of four boys. His sister Ruth was born 2 years later. When Disney was 4 years old, the family moved to Missouri, USA. They settled on a farm near the town of Marceline. Everyone worked on the farm. Disney helped care for the cows, pigs, ducks, and chickens. He liked spending time with the animals and drawing pictures of them. Disney had few art supplies, so he sketched on anything he could find, even toilet paper. His father thought drawing was a waste of time, but Disney's brother Roy encouraged him. Roy was 8 years older, but the two boys were close. When Disney was 9 years old, his father sold the farm. Disney cried as he watched the animals being led away by new owners. His lifelong love of animals and nature had begun on that farm. The family moved to Kansas City, Missouri. Disney's father ran a large newspaper route there. Disney helped deliver papers. He got up at 3:30 a.m. to do his morning paper route before school. After school, he delivered the evening paper.
They gave me a small route. Oh, I must have had 15 customers. I was about 9 or 10 when I started that. In the winter, we'd go out at 3:30 in the morning right after a blizzard or in a blizzard or in pouring rain. It didn't matter. I did that for 6 years. It was tough.
There was little time left for fun, but Disney did not stop drawing. He sketched at school and at night when his homework was done. His father even agreed to let him take an art class on Saturday mornings. When Disney was 15, he got a summer job selling newspapers, sodas, and snacks to passengers on trains. Disney liked riding the trains and seeing new places. A young artist. Soon, Disney's father found work in Chicago, and the family moved again. There, Disney drew cartoons for his high school newspaper. He also took art classes 3 nights a week. Over in Europe, World War I was raging. 16-year-old Disney wanted to do his part. He left school and signed up with the Red Cross to drive an ambulance. Disney was sent to France in November 1918. The war had just ended, but the Red Cross still needed drivers. Disney stayed in France for 9 months.
Finally, this kid came in to me very excited. He said, there's something just for me, dear, that you and I can get in. I said, what is it? He says, an ambulance unit. I was assigned to evacuation hospital number 5 in Paris.
When Disney returned to the United States, he moved back to Kansas City. He got a job with a company that made short films. There, Disney learned about animation.
So I went into this Kansas City film ad company. So that was where I got started in the animation business.
2 years later, in 1922, Disney left his job and started his own company called Laugh-O-Gram Films. He made short films that took well-known fairy tales and made them funny. Those cartoons were shown in theaters before the main feature. Disney worked hard, but he didn't make enough money to pay all his bills. He had to close the company.
I learned a lot out of that. And I think it's important to have a good failure when you're young, you know?
Back in business. Disney was 21 years old. He had only $40 in his pocket and no job. he packed everything he owned into one suitcase and took a train to Hollywood, California, USA. The movie business was growing there. He hoped to find work at a movie studio. No one hired him, so Disney started drawing cartoons again. His brother Roy was living in California too. The brothers teamed up to create a new company, Disney Brothers Studios.
We established the first animated cartoon studio in Hollywood.
Disney worked on a series of short films called the Alice Comedies, which he'd started in Kansas City. They were about a girl who traveled into a cartoon world. Putting a live person into a cartoon was something new, and people liked it. Disney was asked to make more Alice films. He hired people to keep up with the work. One of the people Disney hired was Lillian Bounds. They soon began dating, and on July 13, 1925, they were married. New characters. Disney made 57 Alice films. Then people began to lose interest in them. A man at the company that bought Disney's cartoons and sent them to theaters asked Disney to create a new cartoon. Disney created Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. The Oswald cartoons were a great success. But soon the man who had hired Disney decided he would make the Oswald cartoons himself. Even worse, he hired away almost all of Disney's artists to do the work. Disney lost both the character he had created and most of his best artists. He was angry and sad. Disney needed a new idea to keep the studio going. He started thinking about a cheerful mouse with big ears. He called the mouse Mortimer. Lillian Disney didn't like that name. They agreed on another one, Mickey. As work started on the Mickey Mouse cartoons, something exciting was happening in movies. They now had sound. Disney was determined to add sound to his cartoons. Steamboat Willie premiered on November 18, 1928. It was Disney's first cartoon with sound. It also introduced Mickey to the world.
Mickey was simply a little personality assigned to the purposes of laughter.
Disney soon started another series of cartoons called Silly Symphonies.
I had another idea which was plaguing my brain. It was the Silly Symphonies.
One of them, Flowers and Trees, was Disney's first color cartoon. It was released in 1932. It was the first animated film to win a special movie award called an Oscar. By that time, Disney was so busy creating new ideas that he no longer had time for drawing. He left that to the people who worked for him. He said they did a better job than him anyway. Doing the Impossible. In 1933, the Disney's daughter, Diane, was born. 3 years later, Disney and his wife adopted a baby girl, Sharon. Disney enjoyed spending time with his daughters, but he was also busy at his studio. Disney was working on his biggest idea yet. He wanted to make a feature-length animated movie. People said his idea was too risky. It would take too much time and money to make an animated feature. And who would go to a theater to watch such a long cartoon? Some made fun of his idea, calling it Disney's Folly.
I saw it in Kansas City one time when I was a newsboy. They had a big showing for all the newsboys, and I went and saw Snow White. It's probably one of my first big feature pictures I'd ever seen.
It took 3 long years to make Disney's animated feature. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs premiered in Los Angeles, California on December 21st, 1937.
We had a big premiere, the Carthay Circle Theater, big, grand Hollywood premiere. All of Hollywood brass turned out for a cartoon.
The movie made people laugh and cry. At the end of the film, they stood and cheered. The movie made $8 million worldwide, more than any other film up to that time. More animated films followed. Pinocchio, Fantasia, Bambi, and Dumbo. Walt Disney Studios was a busy place, and Disney was still trying new things. Disney started making live-action movies, such as Treasure Island. He made nature films, too. Camera crews traveled all around the world to film animals and nature. The first of those films was Seal Island, released in 1948. By the 1950s, there was a new type of entertainment, television. In 1954, Disney began his own TV show, Disneyland. The program was different each week. The series included cartoons, nature films, and updates on Disney's newest project, a park called Disneyland.
Television was the start of Disneyland.
A happy place. Disney had been planning his park for years. He wanted it to be a clean, fun place for the whole family. People said it would cost too much, but that didn't stop Disney. Disneyland opened on July 17, 1955 in Anaheim, California.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land.
The day did not go smoothly. People waited in long lines in 100-degree heat. Some rides broke down, and there weren't enough water fountains. Even with first-day problems, Disneyland was a success. 1 million people visited the park in just the first 7 weeks.
The park means a lot to me in that something will never be finished. Something that I can keep developing and adding to. Not only can I add things, but even the trees will keep growing. The thing will get more beautiful every year.
The dream lives on. Disney was busy with Disneyland and his television shows. He also worked on a movie based on the book Mary Poppins. The movie starred live actors. For fun, Disney added cartoon characters too. That movie, released in 1964, became one of his most successful films.
Suppose the staff had finally conceded that I knew what I was doing.
By that time, Disney was buying land for another theme park. It was to be built in Orlando, Florida, USA, and would be even bigger than Disneyland.
Here in Florida, we have something special we never enjoyed at Disneyland. The blessing of size. There's enough land to hold all the ideas and plans we can possibly imagine.
But Disney did not live to see that dream come true. He died of lung cancer on December 15, 1966. His brother Roy completed work on the new park. He named it Walt Disney World. It was his way to honor his brother. The park opened on October 1st, 1971. Today, families enjoy happy times at Disney parks all around the world. Walt Disney Studios continues to be a busy place, releasing new movies each year. Walt Disney never stopped dreaming, and even now, his dream lives on.
I only hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse.